Hello. Today we have talked about variable torsion, and as a summary, there are three cases. The first one, the basic one, we only have torques applied at the ends of a bar, but we have seen that the bar has three steps, different cross-section. From AB we have the highest polar moment of inertia, and then it reduces to a second polar moment of inertia, and then to a third one. These changes in cross-section affect the calculation of the shear stresses due to torsion, as in the formula in the previous classes, and it also affects the calculation of the angle. The total angle between A and D is going to be the sum of the angle of segment AB plus the angle of segment BC plus the angle of segment CD. An important fact that you need to remember is that this is a sum, and the sign is important because it will indicate you how the bar is deforming. Okay? This is the first case, change in cross section. The only thing we need to do is calculate the appropriate polar moment of inertia. Okay? There are only torques at the ends of the bar. And then we proceed to the second case, in which we have a change in internal torques. This is a constant and uniform circular bar under torsion. But we see in this example four different external torques. And the question is, which torque do I use to calculate the stresses and to calculate the angles? And my answer is all of them, but not in a straightforward manner. You are not going to put the torque number one in section AB just like that. You need to remember what you were doing in statics, that is, sections. And the convention of sections that I like is that I remain with the left hand side of the section, and by equilibrium there is an internal torque appearing. I make sum of torques and I get the value of the internal torque in this section of the bar AB. And in this case, but in this case only, is equal to T1. Okay? For the second section, we include what we see when we cut here and we remain with the left hand side of this thing. We see the internal torque BC appearing, and by equilibrium we know that it's equal to T1 minus T2. And this is the internal torque in the whole section B to C. We are going to use this internal torque when we calculate the internal shear stress in the bar and the deformation angle phi from B to C. And finally, the last section is CD. We see already three external torques, and this is the value given by this equilibrium equation. Now, when we talk about shear stresses, in this case number two, when we have changed internal torques, we don't put in this formula of shear stresses the external torques. What we put is the internal torques that we evaluated using sections. Okay? And you see, in this case number two, the radius remains constant, and so does the polar moment of inertia. Okay? For the angle, we also need to include the appropriate values for the segment AB, internal torque AB, length of the segment AB, G and IP remain constant in this case, and so on for the two other segments of the bar. What is the total angle between A and D? The two ends of the bar is the sum of the internal angles, or these deformation angles due to torsion. But we need to be aware that each of these internal torques might have a different sign. So when we do the sum, we may have some angles that are positive and some that are negative, and this sign has to be included in this formula, that is, for the total or the relative angle between the two ends. Okay? Finally, we have the case number three, that is the combination of the two cases. And we have change in cross sections and change in internal torques. Okay? We do sections again to find the values of internal torques, and we have different polar moment of inertia and radius, So this is a summary of the angles and the shear stresses formula. For instance, for segment AB, we need to find the internal torque AB with the procedure of sections that we just discussed. We need to have the radius in this section, and it's different, the radius for each of the sections of the bar. And also, the polar moment of inertia is going to change from AB to BC, and another one for CD. Okay? And these are the formulas. Again, when you find the angles, you only use the length of A to B, not the whole length of the bar. These are common mistakes in the exams. People don't know, and then they put the total length of the bar in the three values of the angle, or they are just wondering. Another mistake, when you evaluate BC, you are not going to put, I repeat, the length from A to C. It's just the length from B to C. That is the length in which the internal torque BC is acting on, okay? Not a cumulative length, it's just the length of each segment. For AB is this one, for BC is this one, and for CD is this one, okay? In general, you need to find the shear stress using the appropriate values for the segment, for the internal torque, for the radius, and for the polar moment of inertia, and the same for the angle. You might even have a combination of materials and G, that is used, the shear modulus used to calculate the angle of torsion, might change as well, so use the appropriate value. And if you ask to find what is the relative angle between D and A, you just apply this sum formula, okay? This summation. Now, what are the applications of this? Any of you may have a Nissan Rogue car? No Nissan Rogues in this room?
No.
Yes, you do. And you too. You know this car. And Nissan and many other car manufacturers, they talk about the CVT transmission. Have you heard of this?
Yes, yes.
And what can you say about them? Is that you don't feel the changes in the engine when you change gear. Why? Because they have a general case that I'm going to draw. Just wait for me a second to get a marker. They have the shaft that transmits the power, not like this. But maybe they have even a more general case, that is a cone. And this thing is rotating. And therefore you have something in contact with this and moves along this length. And therefore it changes the speed, or the angular speed of the two bars. Because there is no sudden change, no sudden step. In those transmissions, you apply the variable torsion topic. Obviously, instead of just equations like this, maybe you have to integrate along the length to find the angles, and not for the shear stresses, because if you want to find the shear stress at a point located here, you just use the polar moment of inertia of this cross section. But for the angle of torsion, you need to integrate along the whole bar. You can check that in your textbook. So thank you. Now you are ready to solve in your problems that I gave you last class. Three more problems, problems 4 to 6. So it's time to do it now. Thank you.